In this video, I am going to explain movement of scapula. Particularly, I'm going to focus on upward rotation and downward rotation. Upward rotation. Upward rotation is this kind of movement. Downward rotation is this direction. I'm going to explain what kind of muscles do these rotational movement. In first part, I'm going to explain upward rotation. Let's get started. This is trapezius. Okay, and upper fiber and lower fiber do upward rotation. Upper fiber and lower fiber. How come? Let's focus on insertion of these two fibers. Upper fibers attaches here. Lower fiber attaches here. When upper fiber contracts, this kind of vector happens, okay? This diagonal force of vector is applied to scapula. Then what kind of movement would happen? This vector, right? This kind of vector. What is it? This is indeed upward rotation. That makes sense. But why lower fiber? When lower fiber contracts, that brings scapula this way. This kind of vector. How come this vector creates upward rotation? Imagine, when lower fiber contracts, that's kind of this vector is applied, okay? This vector. Now, this force of vector creates upward rotation. If lower fiber attaches here, that would create downward rotation because of attachment. In reality, lower fiber attaches medial part of scapula. Thus, this vector creates upward rotation. Does it make sense? General function of trapezius is scapula adduction and elevation. These movements are, of course, important, but upward rotation is equally important. Why? Because movement of scapula is crucial for shoulder movement. If I say simply, if scapula doesn't move, shoulder doesn't move. Thus, movement of scapula is important for shoulder movement. And upward rotation and downward rotation are strongly related for shoulder movement. Thus, tightness of trapezius inhibits movement of shoulder joint. Does it make sense? That's why trapezius is important for shoulder movement, and of course for scapula movement. There's one more muscle which does upward rotation. That's this muscle. This is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior. This is scapula. When serratus anterior contracts, this vector that brings to upward rotation. This muscle is also important for scapula stabilization. Okay, when this muscle contracts, that kind of stabilizes scapula to thorax. So, when serratus anterior gets tight, you might lack stability of scapula. And of course, for upward rotation. Okay, I explained three muscles for upward rotation. Serratus anterior and trapezius, upper fiber and lower fiber. Now, let me explain downward rotation muscles. There are also three muscles that do downward rotation. First one is this muscle. This is rhomboid. Rhomboid. If you want to be very specific, you can say rhomboid minor and rhomboid major. But in this video, I treat rhomboid as one muscle, okay? Rhomboid means kind of rectangular shape. When this muscle contracts, this brings scapula to this way. What kind of movement will it happen? Of course, shoulder adduction. Plus, this is diagonal direction. This diagonal direction brings scapula to downward rotation. This way, this is downward rotation. Does it make sense? This is also important movement. One more muscle from this picture, that is this pink one. This is levator scapula. Levator scapula. It's a little bit hard to visualize. When levator scapula contracts, that brings scapula to elevation, of course. But look at its fiber, direction of fiber. It's slightly diagonal. So this diagonal vector creates downward rotation, like rhomboid. If fiber of levator scapula is completely vertical, that wouldn't create downward rotation. But this diagonal vector creates downward rotation. Very important. Usually, levator scapula creates tightness around shoulder, this area. Yes, this is also important, but that can create downward rotation. Thus, tightness of levator scapula can inhibit movement of shoulder. Freaking important, right? Now, last one. Last one is pec minor. Pec minor is this one, pectoralis minor. Minor. This is on front part of chest. When pec minor contracts this way, that brings scapula to downward rotation. Other muscles are on backside or lateral part of scapula and thorax. This is on anterior part. It's kind of rare, isn't it? This is also important for scapula stabilization. So, like a serratus anterior. I think this is pretty important for scapular movement and shoulder movement. When pec minor gets tight, that inhibits movement of scapula and shoulder a lot. I think this is quite important for upper limb movement. Anyhow, I explained three muscles for each movement. For upward rotation, trapezius, upper fiber, lower fiber, and serratus anterior. For downward rotation, rhomboid, levator scapula, and pectoralis minor. When these muscles get tight, that inhibit movement of scapula, then movement of scapula is related to shoulder joint. Thus, today's muscles are so important for shoulder movement. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.